Hey guys, I'm here at a system that we installed in February of this year. The tenant called and said her electric bill yesterday. I don't know how you can keep track of daily use, but she said it was a lot higher than normal. And the electric company said it's because her furnace is running all the time. So let's go see what's going on. I haven't made it in yet, but it is not constantly running out here. And she said it's maintaining like 66, 67 degrees. I don't think she's made it here from work yet. See if we have any error codes out here. I got us a dead frog. Steady flash. Flash is normal. I'm not seeing a problem out here. If it were locked out because of low pressure or something, I would be able to see that. That may be her right there. So let's put this back together real quick and make sure there's not something going on up in the attic. Come out here and check pressures when we're, make sure the heat strips aren't on or something like that. Okay, inside it, it was 67 degrees. And somebody came out here and told her it was her air conditioner. They didn't even come out. They just told her, according to their usage over at the electric company, that her furnace was running constantly. Turned it to heat and that line is cold. Let's see if I'm getting the right call on my thermostat wire. I am not. That would explain why she's having troubles. Let me check things inside. Blue is where it's supposed to be, white, red. All right, let's check the programming. It is programmed right. And I have the heat on, so let's check things up top. Common is grounded on these. It's in the heat mode, so this ought to I got no 24 volts. All right, next step is to go to the thermostat. See if we got a signal outside. All right, so she has a pay-as-you-go plan with her electric company. So they send her a notification every day of how many kilowatts she has used. That's how she was able to catch it within one day. Let's see if we got a signal on blue. We do. I'm testing between common and blue, and I now have a signal, so our problem is our thermostat. I'm programming this out here. Let me go. She wanted it on 5.2 programmable. I'll select Fahrenheit, 2 heat pump, 7 air to air. Reversing valve is B, so you change this to 1. .375, that's correct. Compressor protection, we're gonna turn that down. Let's just do 2. Let's go back here. Wait a minute. Back 430, minimum cool set point. We're going to change that to 68. 435. All right, let's go hook this up and see how we do. That's actually my second problem with one of those thermostats in 2 days. The first one yesterday it had lost power very briefly, and when it came back on, you had to reset the date and time, but the buttons on the bottom of it would not accept any input. So I'm trying to hit select on 2022 and it wouldn't allow me to do it, so I had to replace that thermostat. And this one is one I installed, so, and it's within 1 year, so it's under warranty. 2 in 2 days. All right, so it just came on. I got 27 volts on blue. Let's see if we produce any heat. Yes, we're producing good heat. So that's all my problem was. Well guys, Honeywell thermostats have been my stock thermostats for 11 years, and I love the Pro 5000s. I stocked the Pro 3000s, the Pro 5000s, and if they wanted an advanced thermostat, we'd do the Pro 8000. But this T4 or these T-series thermostats, I'm having problems more often than I used to. I don't know if something has changed with the company. If y'all know that it has, drop a comment. But I'm seriously thinking about trying another brand because of problems like that. Let me know what you think. I'll catch y'all in the next one.